Hey up and welcome to Callum's Corner. So, I'm back. You might have noticed I've been gone for about a week now. I didn't want to upload because anything I did would have just been angry. I was trying to avoid it. Following the fact that football's not coming home, it became apparent last week, I dropped into a pit of despair and depression. That was only alleviated by climbing out into a mountain of rage, I guess you'd call it. A lot of stuff has been making me angry this week. So I didn't upload. I felt like I shouldn't just be angry. And I've woken up this morning and thought, why the hell am I not uploading? If I want to be angry, I'll be angry. It's my rage, it's my channel. So that's what you've got today, basically. It's a vlog of me telling you why I've been angry and doing some things that will hopefully make me a bit happier. And on that note, we are on our way to Burger King for a massive cheese and bacon burger. And I guess we'll take it from there. Actually, while we're walking, I may as well tell you a little bit more. The heat is one of the things that's been annoying me. It's been just impossible to sleep for the past month. Every night I wake up about 3 o'clock in the morning, sweating profusely. I'll go into the bathroom to get a glass of water, and I'll look in the mirror, and I look like a sweaty testicle, like an actual Betty Swallow. It's disgusting. I'm almost done with this heat. And this morning, went to put the bins out, and there's maggots inside. They're disgusting, writhing little sacks of shit that will grow into be arsehole little animals. I'm done with the heat at the moment. I feel like I just want normality back now. Kind of wish I hadn't spoken about maggots, actually, on my way for a burger. Although, I've still got to get on the bus, so hopefully that will be out of my mind by then. I'm quite enjoying this, actually, being able to talk to you again. I feel a little bit better already. But I mustn't let you guys get into my head and try and make me calmer again. I feel like that's been something that's been happening for about a year now, and it's just almost making me not myself. Sometimes I'm angry. There's nothing wrong with that. You know, the way the world is nowadays, a lot more people should be angry all the time, because most things are an absolute bag of arse, and it's time for me to just be bloody honest again, I think, and just let my true self out. Yeah, that burger. Here we go. The promised land. Burger King.
Coca-Cola. James. Didn't go for the bacon double cheese XL, just because I thought you've lost a bit of weight kind of recently, no need to go over the top, just go healthy, go for the single, well, go for the double bacon cheeseburger, not XL. So we'll see whether this will be enough, whether my desire will be sated by this smaller burger. I'm kind of regretting it already.
I'm in Asda living because it's mum's birthday, but it's not all bad. I found some decent fry pans. Great gift because women love that kind of thing, and we also need a new one, so it's not all lost. I'm back home again now. I've got no top on, it's too bloody hot for that kind of rubbish. You might notice, I won't show it all, but my physique is improving. Hopefully soon we'll have a boxing match, but even if we don't, it feels good to look good. What I did want to talk to you about is another thing that's been triggering me recently, and that is Love Island. Now, I know a lot of you kind of look down on me for watching it. However, it is great entertainment. I mean, honestly, it's like watching a zoo. There is more kind of collective intelligence. There's a higher IQ in the kind of spunky tissues at the end of my bed than there is in their kind of collective IQ in that house. So it's good to watch. However, what has been annoying me recently is, even for Love Island, morals seem to have dropped. There's one whiny little bint who keeps going on about loyalty. It's not loyalty when you're stealing someone's bloody boyfriend and you're telling them. That's not loyalty. It's just honesty. It does make me worry for the world, you know, how spasmodically stupid and, you know, just disrespectful these people are. I kind of want to go in there and just mix it up, although they are all scum, so I don't think I'll survive long. But if you're not watching it, I would recommend you do, because it's quite funny. It's like feeding time at the zoo, only in a kind of sexual nature. Yeah, good viewing. Just come out to the kitchen, and I have seen something that has reminded me of me being triggered the other night. I'm glad, actually, because this needs talking about, right? You guys know chips are everything to me. I love chips. They're massively important to me. However, I've always struggled finding a good oven chip, you know. You stick them in the oven, they're raw. You've cooked them for about 40 minutes, they're still raw. You put them in for another minute, and then they're cremated. It's always been impossible. Until about a year or so ago, I discovered McCain's French fries. Put them in for the required amount of time, I think it's 16, 17 minutes. They come out, they're crispy, they're perfect, they're lovely, right? So, I bought what I thought was a packet of McCain's fries the other day. The other night, I come out to make myself some dinner, get the French fries out of the oven, well, French fries out of the freezer, and this is what's on there. 5 minute cook time. I'm thinking, what, they changed the recipe or something, right? So I think, well, you're going to trust it. You're going to trust it. It's what it says on it, so you're going to trust it, idiot that I am, right? So I put my chicken Kiev for the required amount of time. 7 minutes before it's due to be finished cooking, I put these in the oven, get my beans on and stuff, right? Get it all out, and I'm confronted with a basically raw, well, it's not raw, because it's cooked, it's hot, but it's just floppy, it's just soggy, it's like a permanently flaccid penis, it's revolting, right? I could not eat that dinner. I had disappointment just clinging to me for the rest of the evening, you know, like the way, when you do a particularly stinky poo after a hangover or something, the smell just lingers in the air for hours afterwards. That's how I felt, just disappointed for the rest of the evening. All because they've gone and spoilt something that was brilliant. They came across, finally, an oven chip that cooked well, and now they've spoilt it by trying to take it down to a 5 minute cook time. And I know what you're thinking, or maybe you just need to leave it in longer. So I've experimented. It's like all the other oven chips that came before it. It's raw, it's limp, it's flaccid, and not in a good way, like a McDonald's chip where it's permeated with extra fat or something. Just as in a revolting little uncooked maggoty worm way, right? And you do that, and you do that, and you leave it in for 10 minutes, it's the same. About 12 minutes, it's the same. Around 14 minutes, it goes burnt. There's nobody in between. It's a shame, McCain. You've spoiled something that was wonderful, and finally, a solution for something that was really needed. And now you've tried to make it better, you've fiddled with something that didn't need to be fiddled with, and you've messed it up. You've spoiled it. It's a lesson. Right, I don't think I can end this vlog without fully dissecting what happened at the World Cup, just explaining why it annoyed me so much. The whole thing was encapsulated with an image that's been all over the newspapers today. Paul Pogba dabbing with the World Bloody Cup. I mean, talk about disrespectful. His jaws were bloody May and he's dabbing with it. Dickhead dabbing is, oh, it's disgusting. And to think that that could have been Harry Maguire standing there grinning on his big, beautiful, misshapen head, doing it for everyone who's got a misshapen head. You know, could have been him holding up Jules Rimet and all of England behind him. Just, you know, it makes you sick what could have been. And the Croatians, you know, I hold my hands up. In the semi-final, they were better than us. And I was happy to admit that. And then after the game, there's all this stuff Modric coming out. They wanted to stuff it down the pundits' throats because they were saying they might be tired. We were just looking on the bright side. Lineker wasn't doing anything bloody wrong. Leave Lineker alone and bloody Shearer. The two of them are just a bit hopeful. They're allowed to be hopeful. They're allowed to hope that they might have been tired. You know, it just struck me as bitterness. No one bloody likes England, and it makes me sick. It makes me sad. But anyway, I think it's probably time to move on from it now. It's not coming on, basically, and we've had to endure the French celebrating. Anyway, I guess, personally, I probably need to move on and start shaving again and cut my hair, because it's not a good look when you look like a tic-tac in the first place. You look like one that's just rolled under the carpet and gathered some fluff. Anyway, it's good to be back. It's good to be vlogging, I guess. I think what I've learned over the last week while I haven't been uploading is I just need to be true to myself. You know, when I'm angry, when I'm feeling stuff, just upload it and don't worry about what people think. It's what I used to do and I enjoyed it more. If I want to do a proper video, do one. And I think I'm going to do a lot more vlogs. I like being able to just pull out the camera and tell you what's annoying me. I had quite a blockage, quite a kind of backup, I guess you'd say. Oh, also, Virgin Bloody Media. I need to talk about them just before we finish, because how they can call themselves Virgin. Someone tweeted this to me. How can they call themselves Virgin when they are shafting me in the arse repeatedly? Virgin, my bloody arse. Honestly, my coverage is terrible. I am leaving Virgin. They are making me absolutely sick with their ridiculous service. I tweeted them. I said it's rubbish, and they tweeted me back saying, oh, why don't you phone up? I phoned up. I'm not an idiot. I phoned up. I spent 40 minutes on the phone to someone who barely speaks English to tell me there's an outage in my area. That's what I was phoning to tell you. I want it back. Anyway, I'm going to Sky. Yeah, I don't care about it anymore. I've just had enough. And the annoying noises on the control as well if you press the wrong button. It's not pleasing. Nothing about Virgin is pleasing. And also, I was filming a video the other night. This is going to be a great video. I thought I'd embrace the rage a little bit in a different way. I was going to go live in a Facebook banter group. I finally got it all worked out. Went to go live. Internet went down. I was fuming about this. It was on a bloody Friday night as well, you know, bewitching hour over on Facebook, all the divorced dads back from the pub. In fact, it's not even just divorced dads anymore. That's overstating how bad Facebook is, you know. It's now divorced dads from bloody Kazakhstan. Yeah, you'll see in my video what I mean. Okay, that's all the bloody piss in vinegar. I've got to expel for today. I will be back regularly now with proper videos. I am going to end, well, maybe that's overstating it. I can't probably end Nonsense, but I can put a substantial dent in it with the kind of the music video I'm going to bring out shortly. It needs to be done. I've seen more about this Ian blog noncing people up. I don't know what it is about family YouTubers. They're either incredibly annoying or incredibly noncy. There seems to be no in between. Okay, that's the end of this video, and I'll be back with you for more soon.